Welcome to the University of River Falls. And we are going to have a glass blowing demonstration today at the glass studio, hot glass shop at UWRF. And today's guest artist is Michael Boyd.
Michael, this process compared to the one where you did the, you call that a different overlay where you stamped it and then put the clear the last time over the top of that?
To trap the air bubbles?
Yeah.
Yeah, that's, well, okay. There are these names for certain techniques that Oriflora Glass Factory invented. It was a marketing tool. One is called REL, that's where you trap bubbles, and the other is called RAL. You probably all have heard of RAL.
Yeah.
They're basically just Swedish words that Oriflora's marketing department came up with. Can you go a little bit? Stop. But they're now referred to as those techniques, REL and RAL. Really smart for them to do that, actually. Just glorified potter's wheel, this bench. You can really get on there with the paper and shape things. Make those radiuses look the way you want. You're trying for form to base, right? That glass point. glassblowing is such a hard thing to learn. It's probably the most technically and skill challenging art form there is, other than like if you were getting into something that, you know, some kind of crazy science art. But in that article about the green, you know, in Glasgow Green, they had an interesting point, which is, you know, you try not to waste your time at the heat, you know? And so what that means is really focus on planning what you're doing before you come in. And I didn't learn how to blow glass that way. It was complete, like, every time I came to the hole, what am I going to do? You can even see that today. I barely knew what I was going to do. But it was an interesting idea that, you know, if you plan, you don't use as much energy. And then you wind up with a more fully realized piece. Actualized piece. Famous glassblowers tell me once that it was useless to try and gauge the temperature with my hand. I found that really amazing. So you'll notice I'm constantly doing this, like, okay, that's that hot, that's that hot. And then it's like tasting wine, right? You spit it out and then you taste the next. You have to kind of cool your hand off a little bit and then you go. Really hot, it's great, we have time, you know, it's chill, you know, you get enough heat for both and you can chill.